some teenagers just bang out of order because everybody's like got the same hoodie thing in their mind. Whereas that's not true, do you know what I mean? I have teenagers working for me weekends and stuff. So no two people are the same, are they?
They're covered a lot by the news to be hoodies. So I don't actually think they are actually given as much credit as they deserve, really. Times it's in the news. Well, they don't tend to go in the news for anything other than being goodies and misbehaving, so not really. You tend to only see the bad side of teenagers.
To answer this question, we have conducted an experiment where we will keep 11 teenagers in a confined area for 24 hours to see how they behave when left to their own devices. So now they're in the room, let's see what the first thing they did was. As for food, we gave them enough to last them the whole 24 hours. And because we gave them all the food at the start, they had to use their organisational skills to ensure that they didn't eat it all in one go and go hungry.
I don't want anything, so anyone else can vote one.
Okay. I'll take that vote.
One vote per head.
This ended up taking a long time, and then they got distracted.
Five star cuisine that we've had. That was quite good.
What, well, yeah, smart price?
Yeah, smart price bread, pot noodles. You can't really get much more expensive, really, can you? Classy food, especially when it spills all over the floor as well.
Yeah.
And you have to pick it up and eat it. And there's little bits of stains in as well from the food. That's not brilliant, but. Good diet and everything.
So they had to get in pairs to create and perform some entertainment for us, and perform it to all the group at the end. Each group had 1 hour to complete its task, and as an incentive, the winner received a treat from the vending machines. There were the
Gaffle Green!
It hasn't been easy.
Funny.
Dave,
the bad.
She all over her bedding. She brewed up a fart, then came from the heart. It forced her boyfriend to cancel the wedding.
Yeah. And they're just plain terrible.
Yeah,
that's fine. Second was Matt and Anthony. Harry and Mercedes won.
Yay! We win the stuff! Thank you! We win!
Oh,
Matt! Oh my god!
We then gave them a little dolly to play with and to look after. And naturally, one of the housemates abused it. And if there ever was a doubt about how teenagers are portrayed in the media, this has now been abolished. We then asked the local bus company what they thought about teenagers, and they said around 99% of them were good, but it's just the odd handful that bring it down for everyone else. And this is a cause for concern, as it shows that the media are only focusing on the bad 1%. As the evening went on, it showed that just having someone to talk to wasn't enough, and then with not having any of their personal belongings to occupy them, boredom set in. We'll be right back. was like hoodie stabbing people.
No, that's not fair, no. No. There's different like types of like trends and stuff, and like you can't blame like all teenagers on one trend and one type of people. So no, it's not fair, no.
No, I don't think they are. No, because that is true, that you only do see them as what are the environment and the rock that we're in the
I suppose in lots of cases, yeah, you're not all a bad lot. I mean, I was a teenager once and did the odd thing, but some of the things they get up to, obviously it's a minority, they always spoil it for the majority. But yeah. On the whole, yeah, I suppose the media do latch on to something. There's no good news, is there? You know, they always latch on to something bad if they can to like sell the newspapers. You know, so-and-so stabbed so-and-so in London, and this is how it goes on, as you know.
Somehow, yeah. Would you agree?
Yeah.
I don't see like the bad ones and bad things happen. You never see like the good praise that they get or anything.
Hello, darling.
You never see that, do you?
No, very rarely.
It's always negative.
Do you feel that teenagers are portrayed unfairly in the media, what with like the hoodies and everything? And do you feel that that's unfair and that they only show the bad side of teenagers?
Yeah, they tend to.
Yeah.
Judging by what we've done, then yes, but. I don't think we're all like that in normal circumstances. Yeah, I do.
So, the public have spoken, and they've decided that they're on our side, and that it really is just the media trying to get as much money as they can from the demonising of teenagers. And to prove them wrong, we gave them a general knowledge quiz.
Ready?
Yeah.
Why did the IBM computer called Deep Blue make their headlines in 1997? Because it's an Asian.
We actually are quite clever, really. And they even managed to name 40 of the United States.
Is that a state?
No, Nevada is a state, isn't it?
What's one?
New York.
Z, Arizona.
What's
one? Yeah, that was really cool.
So we've now heard the public's opinion. And now for the housemates.
Do you feel that teenagers are then portrayed fairly or unfairly in the media?
I think they're still portrayed. They're portrayed unfairly. But with your task, if you can find a lot of people and put them into extreme conditions, teenagers get bored easily these days, and there should be more for them to be entertained.
Teens. I don't really watch the media and listen to the media, read the media, so yeah, I would say yes.
What, based on this?
Well, we didn't kill each other or shoot each other, did we?
No, full stop. That would be the shot. I'd say, you know, they always portray us as drug addicts, gangsters, with nothing better to do with our time, antisocial behaviour, all sorts of stuff, but, you know, they're trying to find something to write.
Experience.
It's been really difficult. Apart from that, it's been quite fun. Fun and quite boring, but it's okay.
Interesting.
Would you like to elaborate on interesting?
Well, if with clever editing, you could probably make it look like a porn film.
Favourite part? Probably the task.
8, 8, 1,
go!
Pick
a me!